Hey, what's going on, everyone? I'm the OPJellicent, and we are battling for ICBA Conference Finals up against Dominic Mallano and his New Jersey Naganadevils. He's on kind of a tear right now. He's actually won like the last six games in a row. He started off the season 2-3, and then he ended up going 7-3 and winning his first game up against Matt O'Shea, coach of the Montreal Melodics, in his first playoff game. So we've met here in the Conference Finals, and Dom actually made finals in ICBA season 2, so you already know we got to try to prevent him from making finals again right now, but pretty much, unfortunately, this game does have to be a post-commentary because the original match was played on Showdown, and I just wanted to remain consistent with the whole Wi-Fi thing, so me and a buddy Spanik, big shout out to him, actually ended up recreating it on Wi-Fi. Spanik was a big help with that, so thanks to him for that, and there are a couple turns where there are some different plays made just to manipulate the game so that it looks like the Pokemon Showdown one, but I'll actually leave a link to the replay down below in the description, just in case you guys do want to check that out after watching this video, to check out the more specific plays that happened, because there were like two or three turns that were different in this game, but I'll go ahead and explain through those anyway right now. But looking at team preview right here, my Trick Room into Mega Mawile is definitely very great. We do have a Ghost Team Z Kieran Black, which is designed to lure and get rid of his one fairy resist, which is that Jirachi. And pretty much if we can get rid of Jirachi with our Kieran and then weaken the Vaporeon, we'll be in a really good spot to pretty much just clean with the Trick Room Mega Mawile strategy. So that's definitely looking very great right here. Scarf Flygon's also a really nice win condition right here too. Can outspeed anything so like Scarf Diggersby. He could outbeat like Scarf Darkrai, of course, and that could definitely carry some ice coverage or maybe Dark Pulse. And Scarf Terrakion's definitely a threat there too. Extreme Speed Pressure from Entei is really great too, just to make sure that we can check stuff like Nasty Plot Darkrai in case that does get out of hand, as well as something like Swords Dance Diggersby, and the same kind of thing with the Greninja with the Expert Belt. We do have that Water Shuriken, just to make sure that we can Revenge Kill Terrakion and Diggersby very well in case they do try to set up right now. But yeah, that's kind of the whole thing with Team Preview right here, really relying on Mega Mawile under Trick Room to do some work. Hopefully we can see that Ghost DMZ Kieran Black come through in this match, and let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so hopping into the game right here, I actually decided that I'm going to go ahead and lead off with my Choice Scarf Flygon, just because it can pretty much U-turn out on anything, and he actually reveals that he does want to lead off with the Diggersby, so I'm thinking this may be Choice Scarf 2 and just want to go for a U-turn, so I'm actually just going to go ahead and go right here for the Outrage to try to maximize my damage output on this thing, put in a range of both my Extreme Speed and my Water Shuriken guaranteed, and that actually does a really good amount of damage, so obviously we're locked into Outrage. He goes right for the Frustration, and he'll be picking me off with the Quick Attack right now, so unfortunate that Flygon had to go down so early, but just weakening this Diggersby is really great, because I don't really have anything that wants to take both normal and ground type attacks on my team, as I decide to go out here into my Kieran Black. Now, I'm going to take this turn to substitute, because I figured he may want to try to preserve the Quick Attack pressure, but he just stays in and goes right here for the Quick Attack, which is going to do quite a bit of damage. I was thinking he may want to pivot out into Jirachi, and this could be my opportunity to Ghost DMZ that thing and just knock it out. So we get behind our substitute right here, as he's actually going to go for the Quick Attack again, and the first one actually did not break my sub, but as you guys will see, this one doesn't either. Now let me go ahead and pause it, because in the original game, he actually did break my substitute with that Quick Attack. The first one did 24%, and then the next one broke my substitute, so kind of unfortunate with the rules right there, but pretty much, as you guys will see, in order to replicate him breaking my sub and getting into the exact same position that we were in, this is the first of three turns that actually went like this. He's actually going to bring out the exact same Pokemon that he actually brought out in the original game, which is Mega Pidgeot right here. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit him up with a Shadow Claw right now, which is obviously not going to affect him, just so that he can break my substitute right now and we'll be back in the exact same position. So hopefully that makes sense, and pretty much after this turn, we'll be back in the same position that we were at before. So he's going to go right here for the Hurricane, of course, as I'm just going to go ahead and hit him with the Shadow Claw, which is not going to do anything, and pretty much this is the position that we were in after the whole Diggersby thing happened. So now I'm going to go ahead and just switch out here into my Entei, and he actually ends up critting me with the Hurricane right here in the original game, which is really terrible, because I needed this Extreme Speed pressure to pressure stuff like Darkrai, as well as maybe Terrakion if that's tried to set up or anything, and Sacred Fire pressure could be great for the Jirachi too, so this crit really sucked. Obviously he doesn't crit me here, but he's just going to go ahead and two-hit KO me with Hurricane. I would love to Extreme Speed right here, obviously, but unfortunately he crit me, so he's gonna go ahead and knock me out, and that's pretty bad. Entei's gonna go down a lot earlier than I intended to, but I can go ahead and bring out my Greninja right here. I know we can probably take a Hurricane unless he gets a really high roll. We are obviously max speed just because we want to outpace the Mega Pidgeot right here. So he's going to go ahead and switch out here into his Vaporeon, which makes sense. I'm just going to go ahead and hit this with an Ice Expert Belt Ice Beam right here, which is not going to do that much at all. But I pretty much just have to bank on my Kieran Black not getting burned now, and getting that in safely and getting up a substitute. He could have Roar, of course, too. I do have to scout for that, but we're down 5-4. I do have to make this big play with Kieran Black right here. And if he Scald burns me, that's pretty much just going to be a really bad scenario, because his Jirachi is still at full. I do need this Kieran Black to try to knock out that Jirachi, of course. So he's going to go right here for the Scald, and thankfully, as you guys will see, he does not end up burning me right here, which is really good. And I can just go ahead and obviously hit that substitute right here, and just really hope he doesn't have Roar to phase me out. Thankfully, he doesn't have a rock, so even though I substitute right here, if he does have Roar, we can still come back in another turn. As you see, he'll just go ahead and hit me with the Scald right here, which surprisingly does actually end up 2-hit KOing my substitute. Probably could have played around with my EVs better and prevented that, but I'm just going to go ahead and click Fusion Bolt right now, and do quite a bit of damage to this Vaporeon right here. Put that in range of Mega Mawile's Flare Off, which, as I did say, Mega Mawile is my win condition, so we can go ahead and Fusion Bolt that thing all the way down, as he's going to go ahead and break my substitute right here with another Scald. I really wish I did EV this Kieran Black to take two Scalds from Vaporeon behind the substitute right now, but as you will see, he does end up phasing out me out of my substitute right here, so right now, he actually makes a very interesting play. I don't really agree with this play right here. I decided to go for the Ghost EMZ, just in case he did want to try to pivot out into Jirachi and prevent this thing from going down the Vaporeon right here. But he actually goes for Protect on my Ghost EMZ. Now, I don't agree with sacking off the Vaporeon right there, but I guess it does end up working out for him. I guess it was in range of a lot of my attacks anyway, but he's going to be able to obviously eat up my Never-Ending Nightmare right there. But the big thing was, I'm surprised he risked me actually going for a Roost right there, because if I Roosted up, I could have actually gotten up more substitutes. Obviously, I didn't have a Roost. I was sub 3 attacks with Fusion Bolt and Dragon Claw, and of course Shadow Claw right here, but he's going to be able to eat that up, and now our Z-move lure for the Jirachi is just out of here, so that's pretty bad. But obviously, I can follow this up with another Fusion Bolt and be able to knock out this Vaporeon right here. So we even the score right here, make it a 4-4, and Vaporeon out being out of the way is really great for my Mega Mawile in the back, just because this thing could take a hit if it was at full health, but now it's just gone, and that's really great for me. Crit does not matter, obviously. I actually did not get the crit in the original game, but he's going to go ahead and just bring out his Darkrai right here. Knowing that I'm not the Choice Scarf set like last time, he can just go ahead and click me, hit me with that nice Dark Pulse right here, and that's going to be able to just knock me out, which is totally cool. He's going to be able to knock me out. I love Darkrai too. Darkrai's cartridge spread just looks so cool, but I'm going to be able to bring out, especially the blue eye. The blue eye just looks great, but I'm going to bring out my Necrozma right here, which does have a Colbert Berry, and basically try to Thunder Wave this thing, and I know I can take two Dark Pulses, and this is the opportunity that I was trying to get up the Trick Room at. I could T-Wave the Darkrai and then get up the Trick Room after, because I know I could take two Dark Pulses, even though Trick Room is negative priority, of course, so he's going to go right here into his Jirachi, as obviously I'm able to paralyze that thing, and I'm going to go ahead and get up my Stealth Rocks right here. I'm okay with sticking any attack. The worst thing he can really do is Iron Head me, as he's actually just going to go ahead and get full paralyzed right here. He actually did not get fully paralyzed in the original battle, so in order to replicate that, I'm just going to go ahead and click Stealth Rocks again right here, as he does get his U-turn successfully off this time. So exact same scenario, he's going to go ahead and U-turn out, chip me down just a bit, and bring out his Mega Pidgeot right here, and this series of plays right here is really what's going to define the game. I need to T-Wave this thing and eventually get up Trick Room with this Necrozma, because I need to get Mega Mawile under Trick Room. We already slowed down the Jirachi. Thankfully, even though the Jirachi's paralyzed, Mega Mawile actually still outslows it under Trick Room. He goes right here to the Hurricane, gets a crit, which didn't originally happen, but you'll see that actually ends up making no difference. I go for the T-Wave right here, and this is where I made the big mistake. I should have switched out my Necrozma right here and brought it in against the Jirachi later and got up Trick Room, but I end up leaving it in, which is just terrible. Had he got full paired right there, I'm pretty sure we would have actually just won with Mega Mawile, but unfortunately Necrozma goes down, and that's my Trick Room setter just gone, so I gotta go out here into Greninja right now. We still do have a full health Mega Mawile, which can take hits from quite a few of his last Pokemon. I know we do love a Fighting EMZ from the Darkrai from full health. We can definitely take close combats from Terrakion with the Intimidate pressure, so that's definitely very great, but we knock out this Mega Pidgeot right here with Ice Beam. But really, sacking my Necrozma right there is going to really hurt in the late game, because I needed that Trick Room up. I'll explain after this match why that actually didn't end up making too much of a difference, because I needed the 4 Trick Room turns anyway, but he's going to go right here for the Scarf close combat. I just went ahead and hit him up with a nice Surf right there to an attempt to knock him out, but he's going to go ahead and knock me out right here, of course, and we're going to go right down, and my last Pokemon is Mega Mawile right now, which I know can maybe take some hits. I unfortunately can't Sucker Punch right here and knock him out, so I just need to hope he's like not Fighting EMZ on the Darkrai, basically, as I'm going to go ahead and just Mega Evolve right now, knock this thing out with the Iron Head. I know we can take any sort of close combat, and if he's not Phytanium Z, we can actually win this game, because I'm pretty much going to knock this out. We live the hit from the Darkrai, which is going to be able to not get knocked out by the player off, and then when Jirachi comes out, I just need to hope for a full para, and then knock that thing out with a knockoff. But as you'll see right here, I'm going to go right here for the Iron Head, get rid of this Terrakion, which is definitely very cool, and it comes down to this. Is he Darkanium Z? Not Darkanium Z, Phytanium Z on the Darkrai right now. It is obviously one of his three Z move users, as I went ahead and explained that in the team builder, but he's going to bring out his Darkrai right here, and he's going to be able to hit me up with that Phytanium Z, of course, and that is going to be the end of our season. So we're very unfortunate. He will be knocking us out right here with the Phytanium Z, and definitely feel as though we could have easily won this game had I just preserved my Necrozma, but I unfortunately ended up making that choke, and Necrozma ended up going down, so that's definitely very unfortunate. Had he got full parried with his Pidgeot that turn as I went for Trigrum, that would have been something else. That would have been probably not too funny for him, but we definitely probably won the game at that point. But he will be knocking him out with the Phytanium Z right now, and that is going to be the end of our ICBA season. So he was actually revealed to be Colbert on the Jirachi. He sent me his team after, so I wouldn't have been able to even knock out the Jirachi with one hit for Mega Mawile, whether it would be knockoff or Sucker Punch with the attack, of course. But unfortunately, that is going to be the end of our ICBA season right now. So very good game to Dom right there, of course. And I usually don't do season recaps, so let me go ahead and just wrap things up right here. Definitely had a ton of fun this season. This is actually probably the most fun I've ever had in a Draft League season ever. I just loved my draft so much. Between Kieran Black, Necrozma is definitely one of my favorites in the Draft League format now too, so I definitely plan on picking that thing back up at some point down the road. And I will be returning to ICBA Season 4, of course. We still need to try to win the title, so I will be returning to that. And we actually have a new Draft League starting up next weekend too, so hopefully you all are going to look forward to that and tune in over there. But yeah, unfortunately, there's nothing much else to say. Dom will be moving on to the finals once again to take on either Johnny GB or Omega Jolteon. One coach that we got 5-0'd by, one coach that we have not faced yet. So be sure to go ahead and check that all out, and I'll see you next time. Later.